fits for the great desire I had to see fair Padua, nursery of arts, I am arrived for fruitful Lombardy, the pleasant garden of great Italy. And by my father's love and leave, am armed with his goodwill and thy good company. My trusty servant, well approved in all, here let us breathe and haply institute a course of learning and ingenious studies. Pisa, renowned for grave citizens, gave me my being and my father first. A merchant of great traffic through the world, Vincentio, come of the Bentivoli. Vincentio's son, brought up in Florence, it shall become to serve all hopes conceived, to deck his fortune with his virtuous deeds. And therefore, Tranio, for the time I study, virtue and that part of philosophy will I apply that treats of happiness, by virtue specially to be achieved. Tell me thy mind, for I have Pisa left and am to Padua come, as he that leaves a shallow plash to plunge him in the deep, and with satiety seeks to quench his thirst.
Mi perdonati, gentle master mine, I am in all affected as yourself. Glad that you thus continue your resolve to suck the sweets of sweet philosophy. Only, good master, while we do admire this virtue and this moral discipline, let's be no Stoics, nor no Stocks, I pray, or so devote to Aristotle's checks as Ovid be an outcast quite abjured. Balk logic with acquaintance that you have, and practice rhetoric in your common talk. Music and poesy used to quicken you. The mathematics and the metaphysics, fall to them as you find your stomach serves you. No profit grows where there's no pleasure, Tam. In brief, sir, study what you most affect.
Gramercy's Tranio, well dost thou advise. If Biondello thou art come ashore, we could at once put us in readiness and take a lodging fit to entertain such friends as time in Padua shall beget. But stay a while. What company is this?
Master, some show to welcome us to town.
Gentlemen, importune me no farther, for how I firmly am resolved, you know. That is, not to bestow my youngest daughter before I have a husband for the elder. If either of you both love Katharina, because I know you well and love you well, leave shall you have to court her at your pleasure.
To cart her, rather. She's too rough for me. There, there, Hortensia, will you any wife?
I pray you, sir, is it your will to make a stale of me amongst these mates?
Mates, maid? How mean you that? No mates for you unless you were of gentler, milder mold.
If faith, sir, you shall never need to fear. I wish it is not halfway to her heart. But if it were, doubt not her care should be to comb yon noddle with a three-legged stool and paint your face and use you like a fool.
From all such devils, good Lord, deliver us.
And me too, good Lord.
Hush, master, here's some good pastime to all. That wench is dark. Mad or wonderful froward.
But in the other's silence do I see maid's mild behavior and sobriety. Peace, Tranio.
Well said, master. Mum and gaze your fill.
Gentlemen, that I may soon make good what I have said, Bianca, get you in. Oh, let it not displease thee, good Bianca, for I will love thee nevertheless, my girl.
A pretty Pete. It is best put finger in the eye, and she knew why.
Sister, content you in my discontent. Sir, to your pleasure humbly I subscribe. My books and instruments shall be my company, on them to look and practice by myself.
Oh, Tranio, thou mayst hear Minerva speak.
Signor Baptista, will you be so strange? Sorry am I that our good will affects Bianca's grief.
Why will you mew her up, Signor Baptista, for this fiend of hell, and make her bear the penance of her tongue?
Gentlemen, Contenti, I am resolved. Go in, Bianca.
But this is not justice.
And for I know she taketh most delight in music, instruments, and poetry. Schoolmasters will I keep within my house fit to instruct her youth. If you, Hortensio, or Senor Gremio, you know any such, prefer them hither. For to cunning men I will be very kind and liberal to mine own children in good bringing up. And so farewell. Katharina, you must stay, for I have more to commune with Bianca.
Why, and a trustee may go too, may I not? What? Shall I be appointed hours, as though belike I knew not what to take and what to leave? Ah!
You may go to the devil's dam. Your gifts are so good, here's none will hold you. Their love is not so great, Hortensio, but we may blow our nails together and fast it fairly out. Our cakes dough on both sides. Farewell. Yet for the love I bear my sweet Bianca, if I can by any means light on a fit man to teach her that wherein she delights, I will wish him to her father.
So will I, Signor Gremio. But a word, I pray. Though the nature of our quarrel yet never brooked par, no now upon advice, it touches us both.
that we may yet again have access to our fair mistress and be happy rivals in Bianca's love, to labor and effect one thing specially.
What's that, I pray?
Marry, sir, to get a husband for her sister.
A husband? A devil?
I say a husband.
I say a devil. Thinkest thou, Hortensio, though her father be very rich, any man is so very a fool to be married to hell.
Grimmie, though it pass your patience and mine to endure her loud alarums, why, man, there be good fellows in the world, and a man could lighten them, would take her with all faults, and money enough.
I cannot tell. But I had as lief take her dowry with this condition to be whipped at the High Cross every morning.
Faith, as you say, there's small choice in rotten apples. But come, since this by-law makes us friends, it shall be so far forth friendly maintained. Till, by helping Baptista's eldest daughter to her husband, we set his youngest free for a husband, and then have to it afresh. Sweet Bianca, happy man be his dole. He that runs fastest gets the ring. How say you, Signor Gremio?
I am agreed. And would I had given him the best horse in Padua to begin his wooing that would thoroughly woo her, wed her, and bed her, and rid the house of her. Come on.
I pray, sir, tell me. Is it possible that love should of a sudden take such hold?
Oh, Tranio, till I found it to be true, I never thought it possible or likely. But see, while idly I stood looking on, I found the effect of love in idleness. And now in plainness to confess to thee, that art to me as secret and as dear as Anna to the Queen of Carthage was, Tranio, I burn, I pine, I perish, Tranio, if I achieve not this young, modest girl. Counsel me, Tranio, for I know thou canst. Assist me, Tranio, for I know thou wilt.
Master, it is no time to chide you now. Affection is not rated from the heart. If love have touched you, naught remains but so. Redeme te captum quam queas minimo.
Grand mercies, lad, go forward, this contents. The rest will comfort, for thy counsel's sound.
Master, you looked so longly on the maid, perhaps you mark not what's the pith of all.
Oh, yes. I saw sweet beauty in her face. Such a maid, great Jove, to humble him to her hand, when with his knees he kissed the Cretan strand.
But saw you no more? Marked you not how her sister began to scold and raise up such a storm that mortal ears might hardly endure the din?
Tranio, I saw her coral lips to move, and with her breath she did perfume the air. Sacred and sweet was all I saw in her.
Nay, then, 'tis time to stir him from his trance. I pray, awake, sir. If you love the maid, bend thoughts and wits to achieve her. Thus it stands. Her elder sister is so cursed and shrewd that till the father rid his hands of her master, your love must live a maid at home. And therefore has he closely mewed her up, because she will not be annoyed with suitors.
Oh, Tranio, what a cruel father's he! But art thou not advised? He took some care to get her cunning schoolmasters to instruct her.
Aye, merry am I, sir, and now 'tis plotted.
I have it, Tranio.
Master, for my hand. Both our inventions meet and jump in one.
Tell me thine first.
You will be schoolmaster and undertake the teaching of the maid. That's your device.
It is. May it be done?
Not possible. For who shall bear your part and be in Padua here, Vincentio's son? Keep house and ply his book, welcome his friends, visit his countrymen and banquet them.
Basta, content thee, for I have it full. We have not yet been seen in any house, nor can we be distinguished by our faces for man or master. Then it follows thus. Thou shalt be Master Tranio in my stead. Keep house and port and servants as I should. I will some other be, some Florentine, some Neapolitan or meaner man of Pisa. 'Tis hatched and shall be so. Tranio, at once uncase thee. Take my coloured hat and cloak. When Biondello comes, he waits on thee. But I will charm him first to keep his tongue.
So had you need. In brief, sir, sith it your pleasure is, and I am tied to be obedient, for so your father charged me at our parting. Be serviceable to my son, quoth he, although I, in another sense, I am content to be Lucentio, because so well I love Lucentio.
Tranio, be so, because Lucentio loves, and let me be a slave to achieve that maid whose sudden sight hath thralled my wounded eye.
Master!
Here comes the rogue. Sit up! Where have you been?
Where have I been? Nay, how now? Where are you? Master, has my fellow Tranio stolen your clothes? Or you stolen his? Or both? Pray, what's the news?
Sirrah, come hither. 'Tis no time to jest, and therefore frame your manners to the time. Your fellow Tranio here, to save my life, puts my apparel and my countenance on. And I, for my escape, have put on his. For in a quarrel since I came ashore, I killed a man, and fear I was descried. Wait you on him, I charge you as becomes, while I make way from hence to save my life. You understand me?
Aye, sir. Ne'er a whit.
And not a jot of Tranio in your mouth. Tranio is changed into Lucentio.
The better for him. Would I were so too.
So could I, Faith Boy, to have the next wish after that Lucentio indeed had Baptista's youngest daughter. Oh. But, sirrah, not for my sake, but for your master's, I advise you use your manners discreetly in all kind of companies. When I'm alone, why, then I'm Tranio. But in all places else, your master, Lucentio.
Tranio, let's go. One thing more rests at thy self-execute. To make one among these wooers. If thou ask me why, sufficeth my reasons are both good and weighty.
Verona, for a while I take my leave to see my friends in Padua. But of all, my best beloved and approved friend Hortensio, and I trow this is his house. Here, Sir Grumio, knock, I say.
Knock, sir? Whom should I knock? Is there any man who's rebused your worship?
Villain, I say knock me here soundly.
Knock you here, sir? Why, sir, what am I, sir, that I should knock you here?
Villain,
sir?
I say knock me at this gate and wrap me well, or I'll knock your knave's pate.
My master's grown quarrelsome. I should knock you first, and then I know after who comes by the worst.
Will it not be, faith, sir, and you'll not knock? I'll ring ill! Ooh. I'll try how you can so far and sing it.
Oh, help, mistress, help! My master is mad!
Now knock when I bid you, sir, a villain.
Oh, how now? What's the matter? Ooh. My old friend Grumio and my good friend Petruchio. How do you all at Verona?
Signor Hortensio, come you to part the fray? Contuto il cuore ben trovato, may I say?
Alla nostra casa benvenuto. Molto onorato, signor mio Petruchio. Rise, Grumio, rise. We will compound this quarrel.
Nay, 'tis no matter, sir, what he ledges in Latin. If this be not a lawful cause for me to leave his service, look you, sir. He bid me knock him and rap him soundly, sir. Well, is it fit for a servant to use his master so, being perhaps wrought RC 2 and 30, a pip out? Who would to God I had well knocked at first then and not Grumio come by the worst?
A senseless villain, good Hortensio. I bade the rascal knock upon your gate and could not get him from my heart to do it.
Knock at the gate? Oh, heaven, spake you not these words plain? Sirrah, knock me here, wrap me here, knock me well and knock me soundly. And come you now with knocking at the gate?
Sirrah, be gone or talk not, I advise you.
To go, patience, I am Grumio's pledge. Why, this is a heavy chance twixt him and you, your ancient, trusty, pleasant servant, Grumio. And tell me now, sweet friend, what happy gale blows you to Padua here from old Verona?
Such wind as scatters young men through the world to seek their fortune farther than at home, where small experience grows. But in a few, Signor Hortensio, thus it stands with me. Antonio, my father, is deceased, and I have thrust myself into this maze, happily to wive and thrive as best I may. Crowns in my purse I have, and goods at home, and so am come abroad to see the world.
Petruchio, shall I then come roundly to thee and wish thee to a shrewd, ill-favored wife? Thou'dst thank me but a little for my counsel, and yet I'll promise thee she shall be rich and very rich. But thou art too much my friend, and I'll not wish thee to...
Signor Hortensio, twixt such friends as we, few words suffice, and therefore, if thou know one rich enough to be Petruchio's wife, as wealth is burden of my wooing dance, be she as foul as was Florentia's love, as old as Sibyl, and as cursed and shrewd as Socrates' Xantippe, or worse, she moves me not, or not removes at least affection's edge in me. Were she as rough as are the swelling Adriatic seas, I come to wive it wealthily in Padua. If wealthily, then happily in Padua.
No, nay, look you, sir, he tells you flatly what his mind is. Why, give him gold enough, and marry him to a puppet or an aglet baby, or an old trot with ne'er a tooth in the head, though she have as many diseases as 2 and 50 horses. Why, nothing comes amiss, so money comes with all.
Petruchio, since we are stepped thus far in, I will continue that I broached in jest. I can, Petruchio, help thee to a wife with wealth enough and young and beauteous, brought up as best becomes a gentlewoman. Her only fault, and that is false enough, is that she is intolerable cursed and shrewd and throward so beyond all measure that were my state far worse than it is, I would not wed her for a mine of gold.
Hortensio, peace, thou knowest not gold's effect. Tell me her father's name, and 'tis enough, for I will board her, though she chide as loud as thunder when the clouds in autumn crack.
Her father is Baptista Minola, an affable and courteous gentleman. Her name is Catherina Minola, renowned in Padua for her scolding tongue.
I know her father, though I know not her, and he knew my deceased father well. I will not sleep, Hortensio, till I see her. Oh. And therefore, let me be thus bold with you to give you over at this first encounter, unless you will accompany me thither.
I'll pay you, sir. Let him go while the humour lasts. And my word, and she knew him as well as I do, she would think scolding would do little good upon him. She may perhaps call him half a score knaves or so. Why, that's nothing. And he begin once, he'll rail in his rope tricks. I'll tell you what, sir, and she stand but a little, he will throw a figure in her face and so disfigure her with it that she shall have no more eyes to see withal than a cat. You know him not, sir.
Tarry, Petruchio, I must go with thee. Foreign Baptistus keep my treasuries. He hath the jewel of my life in hold, his youngest daughter, beautiful Bianca. And her withholds from me and other more suitors to her and rivals in my love. Supposing it a thing impossible for those defects I have before rehearsed, that ever Katharina will be wooed. Therefore, this order hath Baptista ten, that none shall have access unto Bianca till Catherine the Cursed have got a husband.
Catherine the Cursed? A title for a maid, of all titles the worst.
Now shall my friend Petruchio do me grace and offer me, disguised in sober robes, to old Baptista as a schoolmaster, well seen in music, to instruct Bianca, that so I may, by this device at least, have leave and leisure to make love to her, and unsuspected court her by herself.
Here's no knavery. See to beguile the old folks how the young folks lay their heads together. Master, master, look about you. Who goes there?
Peace, Grumio. It is a rival of my love. Petruchio, stand by a while.
A proper stripling and an amorous.
Very well. I have perused the note. Hark you, sir. I'll have them very fairly bound. All books of love, see that at any hand. And see you read no other lectures to her, you understand me? Over and beside Signor Baptista's liberality, I'll mend it with a largess. And take your papers, too, and let me have them very well perfumed, for she is sweeter than perfume itself to whom they go to. What will you read to her?
Whate'er I read to her, I'll plead for you as for my patron, stand you so assured, as firmly as yourself was still in place, yea, and perhaps with more successful words than you. Unless you were a scholar, sir.
Oh, this learning, what a thing it is.
Oh, this woodcock, what an ass it is.
Peace, sir.
Grumio, mum. God save you, Signor Gremio.
And you're well met, Signor Atencio. Trow you whither I am going? To Baptista Minola. I promise to inquire carefully about a schoolmaster for the fair Bianca, and by good fortune I have lighted well on this young man, for learning and behaviour fit for her turn, well read in poetry and other books. Good ones, I warrant ye.
It is well. And I have met a gentleman hath promised me to help one to another, a fine musician, to instruct our mistress. So shall I no whit be behind in duty to fair Bianca, so beloved of me?
Beloved of me, and that my deeds shall prove.
Oh, that his bag shall prove.
Grimio, tis now no time to vent our love. Listen to me, and if you speak me fair, I'll tell you news indifferent good for either. Here is a gentleman whom by chance I met, upon agreement from us to his liking, will undertake to woo cursed Catherine, yea, and to marry her, if her dowry please.
So said, so done is well. Hortensio, have you told him all her faults?
I know she's an irksome, brawling scold. If that be all, masters, I hear no harm.
No, says me so, friend. What countryman?
Born in Verona, old Antonio's son. My father dead, my fortune lives for me. And I do hope good days and long to see.
Oh, sir, such a life with such a wife were strange. But if you have a stomach to it, a God's name, you shall have me assisting you in all. But will you woo this wild cat?
Will I live?
Will he woo her? Aye, or I'll hang her.
Why came I hither but to that intent? Think you a little din can daunt mine ears? Have I not in my time heard lions roar?
Aye.
Have I not heard the sea, puffed up with winds, rage like an angry boar, chafed with sweat? Have I not heard great ordnance in the field and heaven's artillery, thunder in the skies?
Ooh.
Have I not in a pitched battle heard loud larums, neighing steeds, and trumpets clang? And do you tell me of a woman's tongue that gives not half so great a blow to hear as will a chestnut in a farmer's fire? Tosh, tosh, fear boys with bugs.
For he fears none.
Hortensio, hark. This gentleman is happily arrived, my mind presumes, for his own good and ours.
I promised we would be contributors and bear his charge of wooing whatsoever.
And so we will, provided that he win her.
I would I were sure of a good dinner.
Gentlemen, God save you. If I may be bold, tell me, I beseech you, which is the readiest way to the house of Signor Baptista Minola?
He that has the two fair daughters. Is he you mean?
Even he Biondello?
Hark you, sir. You mean not her to...
Perhaps him and her, sir. What have you to do?
Not her the chide, sir, at any hand, I pray.
Oh, I love no chider, sir. Biondello, let's away.
Well begun, Tranio. Sir, a word ere you go. Are you a suitor to the maid you talk of, yea or no?
And if I be, sir, is it any offence?
No, if without more words you'll get you hence.
Why, sir, I pray, are not the streets as free for me as for you?
But so is not she.
For what reason, I beseech you?
For this reason, if you will know, that she's the choice love of Signor Gremio.
That she's the chosen of Signor Hortensio.
Softly, my masters. If you be gentlemen, do me this right. Hear me with patience.
Baptista is a noble gentleman to whom my father is not all unknown, and were his daughter fairer than she is, she may more suitors have, and me for one. Fair leader's daughter have 1,000 wooers. Then well, one more may fair Bianca have. And so she shall. Lucentio shall make one, though Paris came in hope to speed alone.
What? This gentleman will out-talk us all.
Sir, give him head. I know he'll prove a jade.
Hortensio, to what end are all these words?
Sir, let me be so bold as ask you. Did you yet ever see Baptista's daughter?
No, sir. But here I do that he hath too. The one as famous for her scolding tongue as is the other for beauteous modesty.
Sir, the first's for me. Let her go by.
Yea, leave that labor to great Hercules. Oh, let it be more than outsiders 12.
Sir, understand you this of me, sooth. The youngest daughter whom you hearken for, her father keeps from all access of suitors and will not promise her to any man until the older sister first be wed. The younger then is free, and not before.
If it be so, sir, then you are the man must stead us all, and me among the rest. And if you break the ice and do this feat, achieve the elder, set the younger free for our excess, whose hap shall be to have her, will not so graceless be to be in grace.
Sir, you say well, and well you do conceive, and since you do profess to be a suitor, you must, as we do, gratify this gentleman, to whom we all rest generally beholding.
Sir, I shall not be slack. In sign whereof, please we may contrive this afternoon and quaff carouses to our mistress' health, and do as adversaries do in law. Strive mightily, but eat and drink as friends.
Oh, excellent.
Fellows, let's be gone.
The motion's good indeed, and be it so. Petruchio, I shall be your benvenuto.